Good afternoon, Sarah. We're at this lovely property, spacious home with a lot of possibilities in the village of Cabacios.
We are indeed. It's very blue. We're at the blue house and we are starting in the garden, as is a little bit traditional for us now. We have pears, plum, peach, three avocados, and something else I've forgotten. I've always forgotten something. There's three
Two,
huge olive
yeah,
trees.
two ancient olive trees,
Yeah.
lots of melons.
And what we're showing in a way is that everyone thinks you need a huge allotment to have be self-sufficient and have a decent vegetable patch. And it's just really not true because this, if it had a variety of fruits and veg on it, you'd be completely self-sufficient.
Yeah.
What is very interesting here is he's growing loads of different melons because I was wondering why he must be obsessed with melons, this man. But no, he's selling the melons to the very nice restaurant up the road. So
Yeah.
they must be very nice quality and he's got good soil and he's doing good melons.
Yeah.
So that's quite interesting. In fact, not had one of those before.
And it's just one of several really good restaurants in this area, isn't it?
Yeah, suddenly there quite a few have popped up. I mean, this one had been closed for a couple of years after COVID. It's recently reopened. There's one just up the road there, through Cabacas on the right. We've got three or four that you can choose from within a 10-minute drive,
Yeah.
which in central Portugal is actually quite unusual.
It is very unusual.
Yeah,
You've
yeah.
also got fast, very fast access onto the A13. So you can be in Coimbra in 35 minutes, Tomar in 15 minutes. It is really,
Yeah,
really well
location-wise, it's
located.
great. And this road here is the old road to Ferreira de Desero.
Yeah.
So you've sort of got three lines.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're very well located to get, and especially because the house lends itself and is being run or was being run as a guest house,
Yeah.
you've got obviously access and being able to get there quickly
Yeah.
is very important.
It
You've
is.
got four gorgeous double bedrooms upstairs, lounge, diner. Huge potential for a separate apartment and an attic if you want to extend it even further with habitation. So
Yeah.
it's a business sort of ready to go.
It is. I just want to point out this hedgerow here, which has been very recently planted. All the irrigation's in to keep it watered. So it's going to add some privacy to the garden soon. All the irrigation's in for the, well, what are now melons, which he, as Sarah pointed out, he sells on. She's trying to kill a sunflower there, I just noticed.
Just checking it out.
I would like to put out these, I mean, they are really old. I mean, I've got 300 olive trees. I don't think I've got anything
Oh,
like
you've got
that.
a tomato patch.
It's
There's
just
loads of tomatoes
massive.
over
Oh
there.
yeah, loads of tomatoes which thrive really well here. Jacaranda.
Oh, well done.
Yeah.
Beautiful purple flowers.
Yeah.
If you wanted, there's enough space to put a pool here,
Yeah.
if that's what you wanted. Obviously, you'd put a gate in, but you can do that. There's
Yeah.
space for a hot tub around the back where he used to have his little secret hot tub. What were we going to do? We were going to go into, I think you should show the driveway more.
I'm
What
going
have
to
you got
do
in
that.
there?
I'm going to take a walk on the wild side and
The
step
flowers
out
are very nice.
here.
Everyone grows, and you don't often see lots of flowers. It's nice.
No. But it is lovely. We'll take a better look at the outside of the house in a moment.
So this could also, if you wanted to incorporate this garage behind me, which of course is incredibly important
Yeah.
as a garage, but this area here could just have a wooden cover over it and could be your carport.
Yeah.
And this garage could be
Could become part of the annex.
incorporated into, oh, the doors I've just shut. We've just done all of this once and realized we weren't recording. So here we are again. So you've got a garage. Okay. And actually that's room for loads of shelving at the back if you wanted, because it's far longer than a car.
Yeah.
So then we come into what is we call the annex to the main house. So we're not in the main, it's connected to, but we're not in the main house yet. Just to the left, there is another door that goes out. And here we're going to, well, just show you. I mean, all of this area, you've got one huge room, another small slightly darker room because it's only got one window. The old kitchen and this area here.
Yeah.
So now,
let's have a look at the old kitchen.
Yeah, okay.
It's got a fluorescent light, which is going to cause a little bit of flicker here. But just give you an idea, it's a decent size. I mean, all of these rooms can be used in it, whichever way you want, of course, you know. There's plenty of options.
There are.
Yeah, obviously. And there's lots of it, isn't there? I mean, I'd forgotten just how big this house actually is. It's massive. It feels like deja vu, but we've just been talking about a lot of it. But all those electrical fittings coming out of there, I can only imagine was backlit storage or shelving or something like that. But there's an awful lot you could do with it.
Yeah, the mind boggles. But anyway, I think a bathroom, got plenty of room for a nice long bathtub there, mm-hmm. bathroom, and then you could follow it all the way around with storage and shelving for basically a walk-in wardrobe,
yeah.
and bathroom.
Or ensuite, yeah.
Yeah, because I think this would, this isn't a supporting wall, we do know that. So this could be a lovely big bedroom, yeah. bathroom, ensuite.
Deluxe.
And then as you go through to the right, you've got an enormous area. It's plenty enough, big enough to be a kitchen, lounge, diner. But yeah, of course, everyone's got yeah. different ideas on how you may configure it. Yeah, maybe if you go right to the end and turn back, you can see just how long it is.
Yeah, totally, you know. It's a nice little balcony. Well, not balcony, terrace area around mm-hmm. there.
But yeah, plenty, it's huge.
Yeah.
And if that one was glass, it just goes straight out to the garden again.
Yeah.
You're bringing plenty of light into your lounge, kitchen, diner. So, this is just the annex. Now, what were we going to do? We were going to go back around the front.
There's more annex, isn't there?
No.
No, that's the house, isn't it?
That's the house.
So, okay, so let's go.
That. We're going to go back around the front.
Yeah, get a good look at the front of the
property.
The house,
and there's a sneaky bit around the back.
Yeah. Sneaky little bit around the back. It's not that sneaky. But it is very private. So
you can see why this might be commonly called the blue house.
Yeah.
It does stand out. It's very pretty.
It is a very pretty house. And I think the colour actually suits it really well.
Hang on
as
a minute.
You can see there's a nice balcony. And yeah, there's a car waiting for me. We're on a bus route, which you might have just caught. Obviously, couldn't possibly wait. we're also on a bus route, which will go from Tamar.
You've got people hanging out in the bus stop. So this is just access to one other property. And if we just hop over this little boundary here, this is the boundary. That's your window into the kitchen if you just want to reference where you are on the property.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, I remember now. That's also the kitchen. So here's your gas bottle.
Gas bottle storage.
That's area. The window into the room with the weird electrics.
Yeah.
I don't know if that could be a bathroom.
Okay.
And the hot tub used to be up here, so there's plenty of space here for a hot tub.
Yeah.
You could put a wooden
jacuzzi, whatever.
At the top
yeah.
of it. Remember, so now what's that?
What like
we call this? We call it storage, don't we, yeah. I guess?
Yeah, I mean, it's a large attic storage area, isn't it? I mean, I don't think there's any point in.
No, but it does mean that everything that you want to store from the garage, for example, if you're wanting to put the garage into the.
Yeah. There's plenty of storage room in there.
Yeah. In the whole house, actually. There's huge yeah. garage. So this is quite a nice area.
It is. And it, you know, it is.
It was built in 93. Scraped into. So we turn this to put the dates in.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay.
Okay, so should we go back around the front? Now you can see, might as well point out that all the windows were new.
Yeah.
And replaced when the owner bought it from us. And took on the massive job of painting that wall.
Yeah. I don't envy that.
No, I don't think he really enjoyed it. But you can't really tell, but it's, what do you call it? Cobbledash in English?
Pebbledash.
Pebbledash. It looks a lot better now, yes.
Yeah.
That was a job and a half, I think. Right. So, should we go back through to the front doors?
Yeah. We painted it, I mean, some years ago, and it looks still freshly done, doesn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, no, it's been the blue house for quite a long time now.
Yeah, a lot of houses.
It's just begging for you to hit your head.
Yeah, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to come
around. Whereas I'm just going to fall over it.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh, would you like to come in?
I wouldn't mind, if that's okay with you, Sarah.
So let's see if we can make you... You can't come in. Yeah, you can, if I do the right way around.
Okay.
Fir trees look lovely, don't they?
They do, yeah. Don't they normally
look like
see
flowers,
them?
Yeah.
Flowers like that. It is really nice.
This makes me think of Christmas. But
yeah. Yeah, I'm just going to...
Okie dokie, so...
Obviously, it goes without saying that all the utilities and
right.
usual things are connected.
This for me to get this. Hang on a minute. That's actually the annex. So they're the double windows. And as we see, he's had it done. I can see is myself.
Ah, yeah. Which is lovely. I get two Sarahs. Lucky me.
I'm Gemini. You get four. You're so lucky. Right. So, that's already completely private. That's interesting. And he has the AL license.
Yep. So, if that's what you want to use it for.
And I love the fact that my 70s dress goes very well with the 70s floor. So, that is the annex. So, I'm going to pull that shut.
Okay, so let's close that.
Because that's a separate entity to the actual property down here. Oh, yeah, and actually, our colleague Heather just took a picture and we were the fireplace because we were like, we are very 70s. Fabulous.
That is
love
very
it.
70s, isn't it?
Love That's it.
Absolutely gorgeous. Yeah.
And it actually doesn't take that much. It's just design, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
So we've got a really good sized lounge here. Nice height, ceiling fans. Perfect.
Yeah, it's a really big lounge, isn't it?
Goes into the kitchen, which is... Probably about the same size, just different shape. So, very long. So here we have kitchen diner.
Yeah, stylish. I really like the cupboards.
They're like our old ones, aren't they?
Yeah.
And he's done the same as we did and painted them.
Yeah, I think
So, they can be really effective. We painted ours green, I think, and I tend to paint
it. Yeah, I had a comment on the video the other day, and it's got a property that had been renovated, and I might reference this in the comments because this is exactly what this would have been, an old wood kitchen. So 70s solid wood kitchen.
They're really good quality, and solid wood.
Yeah. And this is what you can do with them with a little bit of effort and about 10% of the cost of going and buying
a new IKEA one,
which would not be of the same quality at all. No offence to IKEA.
God, we're going to have a protest now.
No lawsuits and everything. Yeah.
Right, there's one WC down here.
Yeah, so I'm going to show you the WC in all its glory. Look at that for a WC. Absolutely wonderful.
At least it has a fan in it. Okay.
At least it has a fan in it, yeah.
So, the stairwell's also very nice. So from here, so downstairs, we've got the lounge, the kitchen downer, and one WC. And then we go upstairs, four huge rooms, which have all been done beautifully, as you will see in a minute. But I think we've got a very nice wooden staircase.
Yeah, where is it?
Behind you, dear.
Oh, it is.
It's no being able to get lost into a paper bag.
This camera is ridiculous.
Lost in a paper bag.
Okay, yep. We do have a...
Yeah, he's found the staircase. He's so clever.
That's fabulous. Yeah.
Right. So, as we come up the staircase,
I'm going to turn left
either side.
I'm going to go through the mirror bit as quickly as I can.
As you can see now, the rooms at the front, well, you could have seen.
Well, yeah, I'm just going to come. Wait for it.
Dun, 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 dun.
Yeah.
Lovely size room. So what we've got now, this, although I said we've got four in suites, this is actually a Japan jail. So it's lockable from either side. So in here, obviously, this was all done new when the owner, current owner, renovated it. Large shower, fab-sized shower, actually. And obviously, the doors are lockable from inside and out.
Yeah.
So you'd know if people were in or out. And the two rooms on the other side have individual en suites.
Okay.
Then if you...
Should we see the balcony? Or?
Yeah, the balcony, that's what I was thinking.
Yeah, okay. There's never a bad time to do a balcony. Can you?
But if I open it, because you're just close up the curtain.
There we go. Look at that. It's like magic. She's great at everything.
Oh, we could just sort of stay out here, really.
Very nice, isn't it?
So, each guest on the front has their own private access. So maybe the front rooms.
Yeah.
Maybe they cost more than the back room. You can sit out.
You could actually. I'm going to reverse because of the sun to get it more in.
Yeah. If you will just keep reversing and you'll get the whole length of it.
Yeah.
And you'll see.
No, it's a lovely big balcony, that's for sure.
And literally being able to walk across the road and have a meal and a couple of glasses of wine, you really don't have to worry about driving home at all.
There are several places you can eat. And get a glass of wine, cup of coffee, sandwich, snacks, all within walking distance. There's also a pharmacy and everything, isn't there?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's got it all.
Don't start something.
Supermarket.
No. Go back in.
Okay, so back in we go.
He does it in the supermarket just to embarrass myself and the children.
I don't embarrass myself at all. Now, this is obvious. It's obvious what it is. I mean, it is a bedroom. Currently used as a massage room, obviously, and that is the door to the Jack and Jill bathroom.
Absolutely.
That we were in.
Yeah, it's locked this side. Yeah,
just a few moments ago.
Yeah, again, got ceiling fans. So actually, with the hot,
show that.
But they have got really high ceilings, haven't they?
They have.
Not more than 220, is it?
Oh God, it's loads more than 220. It's like 240, 250.
Well, can't they? Can it?
Yeah.
I'm only what am I? Mind you, I discovered I was 10 centimetres higher than I thought for the last 50 years the other day. I've got heels on. Anyway, forget about that. Right, let's carry on into this room. So we're at the right of the stairs here, and you come in, larger bedrooms.
So it was very neat and tidy.
Oh, it's beautiful. Well, it's already completely set out for the bed and breakfast that it is.
Yeah.
These look out over just the rear garden. Well, you've got that terrace area where the hot tub is.
Yeah.
That view. Then the garden of the neighbours there. And the bathroom. I don't think we'll both fit in. Hang on. But now again, we've got a huge double shower. I'll come out, WC, and a nice wash basin there.
Yeah. I'll get the wash basin in because all of the bathroom furnitures and furnitures throughout the house are really nice, aren't they? So there's obviously the shower. And there is the toilet.
Are you stuck on a shower?
I'm a little bit stuck.
Leaving the first private ensuite, we go into what you would call a master because it's bigger than all the others.
Yeah.
This one's actually got a sofa in it as well. Now, I am going to have to go around straightening up all the pictures then. Right.
Are you straightening the mirror then?
Yeah, straightening pictures.
Okay,
so in here, obviously, this is a large, really large room. Again, onto the balcony. And yeah, plenty of space, en suite. In fact, the bathrooms, I believe, pretty much are all the same.
Are they? Yeah, well, same furniture. No, I never realised that. Yeah. Yeah, same furniture, isn't it? I think it was all purchased at once.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. That one probably looks out onto the garden.
Yeah, there is a view of the garden.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then from here, so currently what we've covered is the downstairs with the kitchen, diner, the separate lounge, the WC, and upstairs you've got these four bedrooms, and we've got the separate, let's call it the apartment and garage. Then we're going to show you the attic upstairs, because that could also be utilised if you wanted to.
Yeah.
And then we've got a main door here onto the balcony. Now, obviously, you would need to insulate.
Yes.
The roof was attended to when he bought it. I'm not quite sure now. I think it must have had new battens. This was all new.
Yeah, no, all the timbers are new.
It was new. But yeah. did they have a new roof completely?
Yeah.
It's eucalyptus, which is very traditional. Yeah, so it had a new roof on it, didn't it?
Yeah.
If you wanted to use this space, you'd need to insulate from the inside, but that's not a big deal.
No. I mean, if not, it's another absolute massive ton of storage space, isn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, it's big and it's got good height. Throughout quite a lot of it, you know.
If you've got children, it's their own private play area, isn't it? I mean,
yeah, there's loads of
loads of different things. Oh, hang on. And I'm just about to fall over. That would have been great, wouldn't it? I just tripped over there and got head first down the stairs. So we've got these two pipes here, which are just like dangerous. Don't you do that. I say that and then he falls down whatever I say. Yeah. He did it in an olive pit the other day. Right. So this just shows you the space you've got upstairs, huh?
Yeah.
Right, okay, let's go back downstairs. You all right there?
I'm fine, thank you.
I'm glad I saw that pipe. I could just see me, that would have been a disaster. Right, so I think finishing up in, we're taking in master ensuite, two lovely rooms, Jack and Jill bathroom. Let's go back downstairs and go back to that fireplace, I think. Summing up, I mean, the potential for extremely large, well, not extremely large, but a large, I mean, if you don't, you could have two lounges, for example, as a couple. One of you might want to watch television and one of you might want a sewing room. You don't need all the upstairs bedrooms. I mean, there's lots of opportunities.
People, what else would you do with them? Their bedrooms.
Mm-hmm. What?
At the end of the day, their bedrooms, what else would you do with them? But
so if you didn't have a bed in it, it could be an art room, a workshop.
Oh, yeah, I see what you mean. Okay.
So what we have is a house full of potential at a very reasonable price. It was, I'm guesstimating, must have been about 7 or 8 years ago that he bought the property from us. And he's done all of the work that's necessary to bring it up to this standard, all of the garden. Location is fantastic. This is a great business opportunity or large family home.
Yeah, that really is an opportunity.
Okay, with the best fireplace I've seen for ages, because I love this fireplace. So, thank you for watching. Please do like and subscribe. We shall see you next time.